Hey, it's Meg from High Scores Arcade, and today we're talking about a period of uncontrolled excitement, a state of wild behavior. Today we're talking about Frenzy, released by Stern in 1982. Now, this game was released as a follow-up to the much more popular Berserk that was released in 1980, and in both games, you are playing as the Soul Humanoid, dropped off into a set of mazes, making your way through defeating a robot army who is working on behalf of a giant, evil, happy face named Otto. Now, you're given very few things to do this with. You can shoot back at them, you can hide behind walls, but at the end of the day, you have 64,000 levels to work through to save the human race. Now, this is one of the first few games that incorporated voice into the mix as well, so you have kind of a scary voice warning you of an imminent robot attack the entire time you play. And in general, this game did not see the same heights of popularity as the prequel did, partly because of its timing, but mostly because of its difficulty level. But it is a wildly underrated game, and you won't see it in the arcade too much because it is at the end of Stern releasing video games. So it's one of the last few titles that they released, so they didn't produce a lot of cabinets. So you won't see them on the arcade floor too often, but it's worth a look if you do. Now, what does excellent look like in this game? I chatted with my buddy Paul D. Now, he's down in Southern California and held the world record in this game for many years with a gameplay in excess of 41 hours. Now, assuming that you can't do that, because neither can I, I'm going to take you through the first few levels of the game to get you familiar with the gameplay and show you what survival looks like on Frenzy. So let's go take a look. Okay, jumping into a game of Frenzy here. You are the humanoid battling the aggressive band of robots that are working on behalf of a happy-faced overlord named Otto. Now, working your way through this first level, you'll see they're not shooting at you, so it's a pretty good way of getting oriented. Now, you can't spend too long on any one level or else this Otto overlord will come looking for you. And you'll see he comes back very quickly. So I'm going to skedaddle on to the next maze. And here I am. This will become pattern memorization after a while of playing. You'll get to know what these mazes look like and where these robots will be positioned when they drop you off. Pretty much be ready to shoot whenever they drop you off on a new level. I like to use these segmented walls, really as my first level of defense, and shoot through kind of foxholes that I created in the walls. And of course, be aware that your bullets come back at you, like just almost just got me there. And you can use them to your advantage. So Otto just got killed on his third shot by a ricochet bullet. Again, you're gonna be pretty familiar when it drops you off what these look like. Gonna get these guys. Again, use those walls to your advantage. Make your way through. That was a bonus for clearing all the robots. Give this guy a couple shots before I exit. I'm at 2,500 in terms of scores. Now, these robots are not so smart, so you can use these solid walls as a hideout. And what they're going to do, they're going to try to shoot you, but they'll take themselves out with their own fire. So I'm going to use that for a while and let them try to get me and in turn get themselves. I'm gonna go over and get this guy's shooting at me here. Now, that hideout trick took me a couple extra seconds, so Otto did come out to the board, so I'm keeping watch of him up there. Get this last guy for 140 bonus and then skedaddle on my way. And this is one of those special boards here. Again, I'm going to use those walls at my advantage. This guy on the top will probably grab himself with his own fire. This guy on the far right here, he's going to take himself out as well. And I'm going to clear the board using my little hideouts. Let's see. See, that guy on the right just took care of himself with his own fire. Now, watch what happens in this board. Kill Crazy Otto and four fast Ottos.
That's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. If you are new to the High Scores Arcade team, we are arcade collectors and preservationists with over 160 original cabinets in our collection here in Northern California. You can play some of them at our arcade at 1414 Park Street in Alameda in San Francisco's East Bay. If you love our mission of saving, protecting, and sharing back the classic games of the golden era of arcade gaming, please like, subscribe, share our content with your like-minded friends. And if you'd like to support our mission of preservation, we invite you to visit www.highscoresarcade.com, where you'll learn more about us and see a link to donate. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.